Praise the Lord. It's a wonderful day, viewer. The Lord bless your day. The Lord bless you. This Thursday, February 27, it is our Hope on Heaven devotional one more time. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the gift of this blessed day. Please be exalted in the name of Jesus. Lord, as we kickstart this day with your word, we ask, oh God, that the light of your word will shine upon our path in the name of Jesus. Every darkness that the devil has programmed into this day, we command your light, Lord, to dispel them in the name of Jesus. Today we shall walk in the power of your light, and we shall end up successfully today. Thank you, eternal Father. Bless us with your word, and let your name be exalted. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Today, the topic we are considering is understanding life. Understanding life. So, wonderful topic. A memory verse is taken from the book of John, chapter 10, verse 10. It says, "The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. And I have come that they might have life, and they might have it more abundantly." Our passage is taken from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 5, verse 10 to 16, which reads us. It said, "He that loveth silver shall not be satisfied with silver, nor he that loveth abundance with increase. This is also vanity. When goods increase, they are increased that eat them. And what good is there to the owner thereof, saying the beholding of them with their eyes?" Verse 12. "The sleep of a laboring man is sweet, whether he eat little or much, but the abundance of the rich will not suffer him to sleep. There is a sore evil which I have seen under the sun, namely riches, kept for the owners thereof to their hearts. But those riches perish by evil travail, and he begetteth a son, and there is nothing in his hand. As he came forth of his mother's womb naked, shall he return to go as he came, and shall take nothing of his labor, which he may carry away in his hand. And this is also the sore evil, that in all points as he came, so shall he go. And what profit that he that hath labor for the wind?" Praise the Lord. Once again, our topic says understanding life. To understand is to outstand. Whatever you don't understand, you cannot actually stand upon it. And if there is anything you should understand properly, it is life, because life is a mystery. And until you are able to unravel it, until you are able to discover life, you might not enjoy it at all. And that is why you see some people, they labor all through their lifetime, because they have never taken time to sit down and ask the creator of life to give them the understanding. But I pray for you and I today that the proper understanding, what we need to know, the basic thing of life that we need to know, may the Lord give us grace to understand in the name of Jesus. Don't forget what I said. Until you understand, you cannot outstand. For you to outstand in the journey of life, there are some basic things, necessity of life, that you need to understand. And when you look into a memory verse, the Bible said, "The thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy." He said, "I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly." And this is telling us that in the journey of life, there are two actors that play a major role. Number one is God, and number two is the devil. And now our memory verse has told us the input of the devil, whom you have to run away from. He said, he has three cardinal and a focus, three cardinal mandate. Say, number one, to kill. Number two, to destroy. Number one, to steal. Number two, to kill. And number three, to destroy. And I wonder, when I see some people walking in the path of this wicked man called the devil, don't they know his assignment? Don't they know the mandate he has come to carry out on this planet Earth? He said he has come to steal, and he has actually succeeded in stealing so many people's life. And if you are part of those destiny and life that the devil has stolen, today I command a multiple restoration of your life in the name of Jesus. And paraphernally has carried out his second mandate, which is to kill. I don't know what he has killed in your life. Maybe your health, your finance, your marriage. There is a God that is called resurrection and life. I declare today that God that is called resurrection and the life will enter into your life. And there shall be resurrection of everything that have been killed and murdered in your life in the name of Jesus. The third assignment, he says, to destroy. But eventually has also carry out this this terrible mandate in your life. But I want to let you know that even if he has destroyed whatever he has destroyed, we have a God that can recreate, that can repair, that can replace. He can restore. So whatever he has destroyed, once you know Jesus, the author of life, he can replace them, he can recreate them, he can restore them. I mean, he can bring you back even better than what the devil has stolen. No wonder he says in the book of Joel chapter 2, he said, I will restore. And if he says, I will restore, he will restore. I command, whatever the devil has stolen, receive better restoration in the name of Jesus. And Jesus came with his own mandate. He said, I have come that they might have life, not that they should have it ordinarily. He said that they might have it abundantly. That is beyond measure. The life Jesus gives is full life, not half life. And that is what the Bible says in Psalm 16 verse 11, that in his presence, that is fullness. There is no shortage in his presence. I mean, there is no error in his presence. There is no little measure in his presence. I believe you have heard what David said in Psalm 23 verse 5. He said, in the presence of my enemy, he said, he set a table before me. And he said, he anoint my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. When God blesses his people, it's always beyond measure. So when he blesses your life, it will be beyond measure. I pray today that your life will encounter his blessing beyond measure in the name of Jesus. Let's quickly go through the writing of our Father and the Lord in the hope and heaven of today. And he said unto them, take heed and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesses. Having life abundantly does not refer to material things. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, 10 to 12 says, he who loves silver and gold will never be satisfied, and the abundance of the rich will not let him sleep. So don't be carried away by material possession that Jesus is not in it. We are not saying that God cannot bless you materially, but when that one becomes your major focus, you have misplaced your priority, because we soon discover where he said that seek ye first the kingdom of God. So don't let your joy be in that material acquisition, but that Christ is in your life, which is the hope of your glory. So a Christian is not identified by how prosperous he or she is, although God wants us to prosper financially. It is even as we prosper spiritually. 3 John 2. He is more concerned with the prosperity of the soul than the material blessing, which is an addition. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things shall be added. True Christians are known by the fruit of righteousness and holy lifestyle. That is what we call misplacement of priority, and that is what is troubling the present generation. They are seeking other things first before they seek God, and many have lost their life in the process. That will not be your portion. When you seek God, he opens his treasury to you, and you assess his blessings, which is actually beyond measure. A young man came to Jesus and said he wanted to follow him. The Lord asked him to sell all he had before he could, and he went away sorrowful. Matthew 19, 16 to 24. Many have lost their place in Christ due to the love of wealth. Today, some rich people are depressed because they cannot give up their wealth for him. Wealth without Christ, wealth that you cannot use to serve Christ, is nothing and is vanity. He said, true prosperity, his kingdom shall be spread abroad. If there is any reason why he blesses his own, is to contribute meaningfully to the expansion of the kingdom. One day, a professor who had just given his life to Christ said to me, Pastor, ever since I became born again, I have just been full of joy. I hope it is not dangerous to be too happy. I said, that is the joy of the Lord. Enjoy it. He was a successful man, but all the while, he had not experienced joy until he met Christ. He got abundant life. What a life to live in Christ. Abundant life in him means you can fulfill your destiny. Peter wanted to be a millionaire fisherman, but Jesus told him that he would become a fisher of men. In Psalm 23 verse 5, David did not say that the table was filled with assorted food. Instead, anointing that ran over. Abundant life is overflowing anointing, overflowing grace, overflowing revelation, overflowing inspiration, overflowing value-added life. That is what is called abundant life. In God's presence, there is fullness of joy. Psalm 16, 11. This is the promise, abundant life. Joy like a river. Stay Stay connected in Christ so you can have abundant life. Remember, godliness with contentment is a great gain. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 6. Before we round up, take note of this key point. Anything that takes you away from Christ has taken life away from you. Don't let anything compete with Christ in you. The moment you allow anything to compete with Christ in you and succeed, then your life has been taken away. No Christ, no life. With Christ, you have abundant life. The Lord bless you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the abundance of life you promise and you also gives. We ask, O God, for all my fear this morning, that whatever may be the thing that the devil has done in their life, those people that the devil has killed their life, those people that the devil has stolen their life, destroyed their life, Lord, as they hear your voice, that you can replace, you can recreate, you can restore. Lord, I pray, whatever the devil has destroyed in their life, we command a restoration, not just ordinary restoration, multiple restoration, overwhelming restoration, in the name of the Lord Jesus. As you go today, go and enjoy life in Christ. And as you return with your testimony. Thank you, eternal Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.